Hello everyone, welcome to JET Softec. Today we are discussing about SAP HANA interview questions. What are the different replication scenarios? Answer: load, replicate, stop, suspend and resume. Before you select any application table, the initial load of tables DD02L, DD02T and DD08L must be completed as they contain the metadata information. Load starts an initial load of replication data from the source system. The procedure is a one-time event. After it is completed, further changes to the source system database will not be replicated. For the initial load procedure, neither database triggers nor login tables are created in the source system. Default settings use reading type 3 database underscore SETGET with up to 3 background jobs in parallel to load tables in parallel or subsequently into the HANA system. Replicate commands an initial load procedure and the subsequent replication procedure real-time or scheduled. Before the initial load procedure will start, database trigger and related login table are created for each table in the source system as well as in SLT replication server. Stop replication stops any current load or replication process of a table. The stop function will remove the database trigger and related login tables completely. Only use this function if you do want to continue a selected table, otherwise you must initially load the table again to ensure data consistency. Suspend pauses a table from a running replication. The database trigger will not be deleted from the source system. The recording of changes will continue and related information is stored in the related login tables in the source system. If you suspend tables for a long time, the size of login tables may increase and adjust the table space if required. Resume restarts the application for a suspended table. The previous suspended replication will be resumed. No new initial load required. What happens if the replication is suspended for a long period of time or system outage of SLT or HANA system? Answer: the size of the login tables increases. How to avoid unnecessary login information from being stored? Answer: pause the application by stopping the schema related jobs. The table size in SAP HANA database and in the source system the same? No, as HANA database supports compression. When to go for table partitioning? If the table size in HANA database exceeds 2 billion records, split the table by using partitioning features by using advanced replication settings. Transaction IUUC underscore REPL underscore CONT tab page IUUC underscore REPL underscore TAB STG. Where do you define transformation rules? Answer: by using advanced replication settings, transaction IUUC underscore REPL underscore CONT tab page IUUC ASSRULEMAP. Are there any special considerations if the source system is non-SAP system? Answer: the concept of trigger-based replication is actually meant for SAP source systems. The main differences are there will be a database connection between non-SAP source and SLT system instead of RFC. Source must have primary key tables DD02L, DD02T which contains metadata or just initially loaded but not replicated. The read modules reside on SLT system. Tables with database specific formats may need transformation rules before they are replicated. Only SAP supported databases with respective DBSL for SAP NetWeaver 7.02 are supported as non-SAP source systems. What are the potential issues in the creation of configuration? Answer: missing add-on DMIS_2010 in source system, missing the proper role of SAP_IUUC_REPL_remote for RFC user, SAP_IUUC_user for SLT system, login credentials are not correct. How can you ensure that data is consistent in source system and HANA system? Answer: since any changes in the source system is tracked in dedicated login tables, the replication status for each changed data record is transparent. A entry of login table is deleted after a successful commit statement from HANA database, and this procedure ensures the data consistency between source system and HANA system. Does SLT for SAP HANA support data compression like SAP HANA database? Answer: yes, this is automatically covered by the RFC connection used for data replication from the SAP source system.